Fu Kritic.
Why the K in Kritic? The K is for Knickerbockers. And sometimes karate. Hello everyone, Kung Fu Kritic here. Why the silly K, you ask? Well, because this is a silly film. It's a spoof. That's right, we're covering a Kung Fu spoof film. There are a few of these out there. For bad or for worse, some are good, some are bad. Is this the good? Is this the bad? Here's a hint. They didn't have a lot of money. But don't let that deter you. Let's take a look and see what funny is available for us. But don't forget, first things first, our cast list. Our heroic Art Chu, played by Michael Mankin Chow. Our evil Helen Hu, played by actress Joyce Brew. Don't forget our two helpful assistants to Art Chu, Roy Lee, played by actor Coleman DiMaggio. Wayman, played by Daryl Fong. Our lovely love interest, Sushi, played by Karina Davis. And don't forget Uncle Wong, played by Wallace Choi. Now, that's our cast. Let the funny commence. Let's see. Now, our film begins with this rather well done martial arts sequence. Our narrator describes this ancient peach that is basically the fountain of youth if you eat it. And we get a good action sequence here. I give them props. They tried some wire work here. Well done, well done. After this point, the peach is taken, stolen, lost to history. We jump forward to semi-modern day. We meet our currently young hero, Art Chu, and a bad, bald-capped master. This is, again, done comedically to be funny. Bringing him in to teach him their ways. There's a couple funny sequences here. I say funny because they're supposed to be funny, not because they are. Art grows up and eventually journeys to San Francisco, where the peach is supposed to be located. He meets his cousin, Wei Man, with his friend, Roy Lee, an African-American man who thinks he's got the stuff to be the next Bruce Lee, but he just concentrates on the films, not actually practicing. He has some good comedic elements here, especially later on where there's a constant gag of him doing over the top with his and then just getting the crap kicked out of him every single time. Again and again and again. Quite funny, quite funny. As they go along, we meet our baddie, Helen Hu. What is this white substance? She's trying to push it on a lot of the shops in Chinatown. What could it be? Naughty, naughty. It's just MSG. That's a good gag. There's boxes through her whole warehouse that say MSG on it, and they do a good job following up on that. Art Chu is then discussing with Uncle Wong, who owns a restaurant and is being bullied by these men to buy this, and he decides that, Uncle Wong, I am here to find this peach. I must bring it back to my temple. Upon beginning this trope, he decides that he is going to go to Uncle Wong's old restaurant, where supposedly the peach is hidden. A few comedic elements here, including a great spit take by Art on top of Helen, which I think goes up there in spit take history. Is quickly finished by Roy Lee punching a hole inside of a wall, and of course, when they leave, the bad guys discover the peach. Helen Hu's gonna turn it into a youthful potion that can be sold for billions of dollars. Ooh, evil. Art Chu finally decides that they must indeed get in, and that's where our love interest, Sushi, must get them entrance. She's a dancer there. They dress up in a dragon costume, quickly, sneakily get to the underground level of this restaurant to find all of the baddies practicing their Fu. There's a comedic element spot here that's also very good. You have a henchman by the name of One Ton who is teaching all of the baddies the appropriate way to make noises when you are fighting in Kung Fu. With your hua, hia, hua. And don't forget, if you're getting hit, you make a hua. If you fall down, you have to make a, oh. Again, props. Funny, funny, funny. Upon them discovering the peach and escaping with said peach, we get a rather comedic element here where Art is reaccosted, brought downstairs, and in traditional fashion, he makes all the villains take a number. Remember, you can't attack one man all at once in a group. That wouldn't be fair. He takes out a ticket. Everybody takes a ticket. And he calls out their numbers one by one to get the fight. there's a good ending to this where he pulls up a sign that says next window, please. Again. Sorry. Funny. You're trying. Sushi is captured. The peach is taken. Art Chu and company must save her. They go in, quickly locate her, and a rather large fight ensues between two different goodies and baddies. I think they honestly went to a karate dojo and said, can you guys do your practice fighting in here? We'll videotape you. It was good. I give them props for trying to be more authentic and pulling off some decent moves in here. At the end, Sushi is saved. The peach is gone, eaten by Helen Hu. But Art Chu must return to his temple. Upon returning, he finds out that Sushi is a secret agent for his temple, sent there to assist him. She was able to save the pit of the peach, replant it, and a new peach shall be born. And that is Kung Phooey. Overall, very entertaining. If you're in the mood for something that's not exactly stellar, I don't recommend this film. Even by a comedic standpoint, strictly on a spoof film, Mel Brooks, the god that he is for making these fantastically comedic films, this one is on a much lower level, and I really don't think you're going to want to check it out. Unless if you can find it for a good price, or you just want to see a comedic movie based entirely around Kung Fu, but still not done to the point where I think you're going to laugh enough. This is the Kung Fu Critic, signing out.
Everybody's favorite spot,